About a month ago in Death Valley, we saw the hottest single day temperature since 1931 at 130 degrees Fahrenheit. This was the hottest single day temperature ever recorded since we hit that mark also in Death Valley at 134 degrees Fahrenheit.
It was really bad. In fact, it was just one of the many outcomes of climate change. But was it really? I mean, it could have just been a spike in temperatures. And in fact, it was.
That's a little bit suspicious.
Yeah.
So we're probably just exaggerating, right? This is not a problem at all. We'll just get over it and this so-called climate change will disappear in a blink of an eye, right? Nope, it definitely will not.
Climate change is very real, and it's the defining issue of our world today. This problem goes beyond all barriers, all differences, all politics, and all species. It affects every living creature on this planet. You, your children, your family, your close friends, your pets, the plants in your garden could all end up in dire circumstances because of the effects of climate change.
If you're a climate change denier who has come across this video, maybe you were intrigued by the title, saw it on your recommended, or were sent this from a friend, we have made this video specifically for you. Why, you ask? Well, the way I see it, we are facing a pivot point in the progression of climate change. Within the next decade, the choices we make as a species could take us to heights we've never reached before, or possible mass extinction of species across the planet. Before we begin our journey into understanding our climate change, we need to understand the tool we use. The tool we use to understand our world and our universe. And the tool we use to understand ourselves, science.
Science has gotten a very bad rep lately. People have cast it off as propaganda or just set it aside as not important. In fact, science is quite the opposite. The use of science is as neutral and factual you can get with solving an issue.
Science is a method. It's nothing more. It's simply a path to answer a question. Just like a mathematician would use a formula or an engineer would use a screwdriver. People who use this method in specific fields within science use it to solve issues within their field.
Obviously, science isn't perfect. Humans are flawed. And even if we come up with the most perfect tool, it's still humans using those tools. So mistakes will be made. But what makes science an important tool is that it does not admit it's right, but that it constantly tries to correct itself, simply for the sake of science and nothing else.
When we're discussing a concept like climate change, we come to our conclusions by measuring our environment, acquiring data, and evaluating its significance in the context of our environment. I mean, this is really how you tackle any problem. If you're replacing a flat tire, you measure your environment, gather all your tools, and put together a solution. In this case, that would be getting the replacement tire out of your trunk and putting it in the place of the flat tire.
So now, it's time to face the issue of climate change full steam ahead with our new tool. Most counterarguments to the existence of man-made climate change come in one of these two forms. The first is to simply deny its truth. If you or someone you know believes that climate change is a hoax, the data is exaggerated, or even that the data is fabricated, that's denying the truth of the matter. So let's get the facts straight.
There are mountains of data which support the reality of man-made climate change. We'll include some of the links in the description. But first, let's start off with global temperature. The average global temperature has increased by 1.6 degrees Fahrenheit since 1906. That may sound like little, but that is a lot.
Sea levels have risen by 8 inches over the last century, and the rate of increase is double the past 2 decades than that of the previous 8. You can imagine just how many floods this has caused.
Glaciers in places such as Greenland and Antarctica are melting at massive rates, with them losing 286 billion tons and 127 billion tons of ice each, respectively. Oh, and those stats I just stated? Those were all per year.
But it gets worse. Our oceans have warmed significantly, with the top layer seeing an average global increase in temperature at 0.4 degrees Fahrenheit. This, along with the 8 million metric tons of plastic we dump into the ocean and overfishing at a massive scale, has led the marine species being pushed to the brink.
Our oceans have increased in acidity by an average of 30% since the early 1900s. That only adds on to the effect that it places on marine animals.
These are just a few of the many statistics which prove the existence of a major global shift in climate, on the scale of many we have seen through the existence of this planet. Now, the next question is, are we as a species responsible for this?
A lot of these effects are direct responses to our excessive emission of greenhouse gases. You've probably heard of the term greenhouse gas before, but what exactly is it?
A greenhouse gas is any kind of gas which contributes to the greenhouse effect. Well, what's the greenhouse effect? Well, you can think of the atmosphere as a blanket. The sun sends energy our way, and the atmosphere traps some of that energy so we can have a livable climate.
However, gases such as carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane, and its more are very, very good at absorbing radiation, such as the sun's rays. So the energy that comes from the sun that is trapped is much better at heating this planet. At low amounts, that is a good thing. It helps keep us warm and prevents every living creature on this planet from absolutely freezing to death. But at high levels, it can be extremely dangerous. You go from wearing a light blanket to wearing multiple weighted blankets on top of each other.
This is exactly what we are facing right now. We are emitting an enormous amount of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Right now, we've collectively emitted about 50 billion tons of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere per year. This is more than double that what we've emitted in the entire decade of the 1980s.
Wow. The greenhouse gases we emit don't just affect global temperatures, the melting of the ice caps, and the rise in sea levels. Absorption of gases like carbon dioxide into our ocean can cause further acidification of the ocean, as we described earlier. This can cause so many animals to die, and for coral reefs, the sources of food and shelter to countless marine animals, to bleach to death.
All of this is not even considering the plastic we dump into the ocean, deforestation, and more. This is solely focusing on the effects of greenhouse gases. The second and more subtle argument is to accept the reality of climate change, but deny the fact that it's man-made. Often you might find yourself or someone else saying that climate change is natural, it's happened many times in human history, or that greenhouse gas emissions which have caused this change are completely natural emissions. This is extremely dangerous, because as more and more people accept this, more and more people start to accept the idea that we can't do anything about climate change and surrender to the ultimate dire consequences.
All the data that we covered today is extremely significant, and in fact, it's supported by the majority of the scientific community. In 2016, a review was conducted which examined peer-reviewed research on the topic of climate change. And it just so happened that 97% of the publications which we reviewed supported the evidence and existence of climate change and evidence that it is caused by us humans.
One common counter-argument to climate change is that this is normal, and it's just another climate event in human history. While this is true that the Earth has seen climate events like this in the past, this argument ignores the rate at which these events occur. One example of this is an ice age. Ice ages can occur over tens of thousands of years. Meanwhile, we're seeing a climate event accelerating to that large of a scale over the course of only 100 years.
Another common argument that we've seen a lot is that people say we've seen a recent downtick in global temperatures. And you may not even be wrong. In the past week, I could pretty confidently say that yesterday was hotter than today. However, by scaling back to a longer time span, you can see that this downtick is an inevitable outlier, which won't be deemed significant when you look at average global temperature increases. It's just another random day.
A lot of arguments against climate change, which have been recycled over the years, tend to be statements that are just straight up wrong. They're simply scientifically inaccurate or completely irrelevant.
For example, statements such as, the sun is getting hotter, or we're getting closer to the sun, are examples of those. There is zero evidence that the sun is getting hotter, and while technically it's true that we're getting closer to the sun, we've only gotten closer by a couple centimeters in the past decade.
In fact, here's an experiment you can do at home right now. Go outside and put your hand towards the sky. Now, look at your hands and make sure that they weren't burned off by the blazing heat of the sun. And just like that, you've single-handedly and instantly gotten closer to the sun than the entire planet has in the past decade. So no, getting closer to the sun is not the reason why we're experiencing this kind of climate change.
One last argument we will tackle is the argument that human CO2 emissions are a small fraction of CO2 emissions from natural causes, like volcanoes, for example. Well, this is not true. The biggest volcano eruption of the past 20 years, which happened in Iceland, emitted 5 million tons of CO2. That's a lot. But this month alone, us humans have emitted 4 billion tons of CO2 into our very own atmosphere.
So where do we go from here? What now? Why should I even care? Well, if we've arrived at the same conclusion, this gives us some hope. Because now that we know that us humans have caused it, we know that humans can reverse it.
So, what's the solution to climate change? The solution to climate change is... Well, there's no one solution to climate change. And even if there was, it certainly wouldn't result in immediate change. The solution comes at a point between individual efforts and public policies. That means the things that you can do on your own and tell other people around you to do, as well as the things that government and lawmakers will do.
On a personal level, we know what we can do. Getting used to the habit of recycling things, using bikes, and taking public transportation as much as possible, and replacing it using cars, taking steps towards replacing animal products in your diet, installing solar, and reducing the number of plastic bags you use.
All of these are extremely important habits that you can install into your lifestyle, step by step, to help heal this planet from the damage that we have put it through in climate change. But of course, none of this matters if you can't get the help of our government officials. Contact your local representatives. Urge them to take action by passing legislation that will help us switch from non-renewable energy to renewable energy. Legislation that will make factories accountable for the carbon emissions that they put into the atmosphere. And of course, spread awareness with the people you know so that they know that they can make change in this effort as well.
Earth is our home. The least we can do is help renovate it to get back to its healthy, pre-climate change state.
We hope you enjoyed this video on probably the most important topic we've covered on this channel ever.
Yes, stay tuned for our next few videos.
Don't forget to check out our website and social media pages in the description and to subscribe to our channel.
And as always, science is everywhere.
And in everything.
Bye.
Bye.